employee like that. They need to be budget, they need to have a deadline, they need to have a recouping point, you know. And Hideo doesn't think like that.
So
He
you're
just
just,
want to make create, you know,
yeah.
whatever he feels like creating,
Yeah.
you know.
Yeah, so you're saying because of his, vision, because of his because of what he wants to do, it made him less of a less valuable business a business person, because he's not the one to cut deadline, but cut and dry deadline, same game every time.
No. He, you know, as you know, as of, you know, waiting for fans to, you know, how long, you know what I mean? He always have a projection date. Of course he's gonna have a, oh yeah, we're gonna release it, but that release date comes like, oh, we're gonna delay. How long? He doesn't know. You know what I mean? Something happened and, you know, he wanted to create the engine, new engine that took a longer than he expected. And, you know, something like that, Fox engine, he didn't
Yeah.
think he's gonna take a long time, but he did, so that kind of pushed it back later. And a lot of things, you know, he didn't anticipate. There's a lot of things in the business he didn't anticipate, you know. So you know, it's just like a, he's a creator, and I think he's a really, really good creator, you know, one of the best. And he is, but he's not a really good businessman, you know. And like when you have a big company like that, you have an employee with six, you know, more than 6,000. You gotta have a business sense. You gotta know when, how can I recoup that money? You know, if you put down $200 million, you gotta recoup at least, you know, you gotta be able to have a recouping point, you know,
You
somehow.
have to have profit.
You gotta have a profit. And he doesn't think about profit. You know, he think that, you know, if it's a product is good, somebody's gonna buy it, you know. Yeah, right. Back in the day, yeah. You only had 20 employees working with you, but now you got 300 employees, staff. You know, you gotta cover the expenses. And, you know, he didn't think like that, you know?
So I guess it seems like with Hideo, for him, it was more about the passion and the art rather than making money.
Didn't care about the money because he was getting paid, you know, whatever that his money he's getting paid for 20 years, the same, you know?
Right. He already knew he was getting paid.
No, he didn't care. It was a delay. He's not gonna suffer. He's not getting like a, okay, you're making like a $2 million. You're gonna go down to 100 million, you know, $100,000. No, it's not like that. So, whatever he made in the 20 years ago, he told me that's how much he's making. I don't know if that's true or not, but you know, he didn't. You know, he doesn't live in like a fancy Hollywood, you know, luxury lifestyle. You know,
Right.
he's a salaryman in Japan. Salaryman, which is you get monthly payment, you know, every month, and they don't even have a bonus. And the Konami believes in no bonus, so they kind of give a little bit more than the regular company, and they break it down to 12 times. So whatever the money, you know, it's the same. He doesn't get
Right.
more because the Metal Gear Solid made more money. No, he doesn't get that either. Before they used to have a profit share, but they don't even have profit share anymore. So
Oh, man.
whatever the money. You know, the video game, the Metal Gear or whatever that he produced may, he doesn't even get that. So
So
it's a
he did.
different, yeah, different type of you know, salary than the American video game company, I think.
Wow. So
Because
he
American company, yeah, different.
gets what he gets, and that's it.
That's it. He doesn't get
Wow.
anything. Yeah. So that's why, you know, for him, it's like, that's why I'm just gonna keep doing what I'm doing, and I'm not making more or less, you know. So whatever the money he's making the same amount of money. So you know, for him, it's like it's the same.
Now, did that work? Did that work for?
Can you help my employee to write music? That was Hibino,
Oh, yeah.
and I had the. What happened is like you know, he did beg me to share my budget with his employee Hibino and help him to write the music. That was Snake Eater. I basically arranged all his music and made it much better than what he had, and I hired a singer, then I made it into a totally different song, which that was a Snake Eater. So I supposed to be writing the music for a theme song. Then you know Hibino had an idea. He wanted to write. I guess he, you know, he's an employee at the Konami at that time. So Hideo begged me to, you know, share my budget and can you have him write the theme song? Then can you write? You know, he knew, you know, Hibino wasn't cut out to be able to do it. So he asked me, can you write, you know, can you help arrange the music and, you know, share your budget? So I, you know, I had the full budget, then my budget got cut down. So I had to write music, something simple and something cheaper. And, you know, and all my budget went into Hibino's music instead of me. So I had to kind of make my music is a lot simpler than his, and just kind of, you know, that's why I end up writing music for jazz, and I could get the jazz musician and the string orchestra, and, you know, it's like one take, you know, for me, you know, so. Japanese, and I think like that because I grew up
music for the games. I just felt like, and no offense, writers of Metal Gear, but I feel like they got too much credit. Especially, yeah. You were behind quite a bit of it.
Yeah, but it's okay. You know, I'm going to start doing my own thing, so they're going to start seeing that. Because, you know, finally, because actually I'm really happy Hideo left, whatever the reason, and I'm really happy he will be able to do what he wants to do, maybe, with that Konami. And I hope, you know, I told him to get out of the company, but more than 10 years ago, you know? Get the hedge fund money and start your own company. But he didn't think like that because he's more Japanese. And I think like that because I grew up half of my life here in America. So I don't really think like Japanese people. So he
really just kind of wanted to take the traditional route.
Yeah, well, like I said, his money hasn't changed for 20 years. So he's happy with just getting this monthly salary. You know what I mean?
Right.
He's just happy getting the stable income every month and be able to create. So that's, to me, it's not a creator. That's, to me, is just you working for 9 to 5. You know, see, I'm a freelance, so even though I don't have a job for God knows how long.
Across all of the games, is there any song that you, because you talked a little bit earlier about how you would rewrite songs or you would send stuff in that would get denied. Is there a song that you absolutely loved that never made it into a game?
Oh, yeah. So I was thinking, like, I had to go into my storage, but I have, like, 20 drives, each one's about 500 to 1 terabyte. So I was thinking maybe I should just release that, you know, denied by Hideo Kojima.
That's what I was getting at, because I'm sure if you wrote all of this stuff for all of these games,
great
there's got to be
great
stuff.
Yeah, exactly. I got great music. He didn't really approve, and I was like, why didn't you pick this one? This is better than, you know, but whatever, it's a political reason. And, you know, at that time, maybe he felt that way in his emotion, because he goes by the emotions, not by the really what sound like it. So whatever the time his situation is, you know, he feel like he wanted to deny, that's fine, you know, whatever. So, you know, I have a lot of music, and a lot of fans ask me, can you release those? And I'm sure a lot of fans will probably want to hear that.
Right. I would definitely be one to, excited to see some of the stuff that didn't necessarily make it.
Yes.
And just kind of see, you know, what didn't make it could be just as good as what did.